I was influenced very heavily by a man named Charlie Walker, who was a Quaker man in the United States who had done a lot of work with Gandhians and South Asians, promoting the idea of the world brigades and the peace teams back in the 60s and 70s. And he's the founder or co-founder of the Peace Brigades International.
Right.
And I was inspired by his work to bring nonviolence to the United States, as well as a man named George Willoughby, another well-known Gandhian American Quaker who devoted his life to civil rights and protection of minorities. So these two men inspired me, and I took a job with them immediately after college working at Peace Brigades International, which is a group that was inspired by Shanti Sena.
That's right.
And Shanti Sena was really the first attempt at nonviolent policing, or what we call third party nonviolence. It's also in some places now called unarmed civilian protection. Nonviolence International was started by Mubarak Awad and a few of his colleagues. He was a well-known Palestinian activist who helped promote nonviolence in Palestine and helped really launch the first Intifada uprising in Palestine. He was known as the Palestinian Gandhi. He was so scary for the Israelis that they kicked him out of the country. They exiled him, even though he was born in Jerusalem. They said, well, you've been gone too long. When he came to the United States to study, you've been gone too long, so you lose your right to have a call yourself a citizen or a resident of this country. So he said, look, I'm not just for nonviolence for Palestinians. I believe in nonviolence. Even though my father was killed by the Israelis, I was raised with the idea that I don't want to kill anybody else. And I want to promote nonviolence around the world. It's not just a Palestinian kind of idea. And so he came to the United States and opened this up and recruited me to come and join him in promoting nonviolence around the world. And we've just had a glorious ride. We've had networks around the world in which we promote nonviolence. We're not limiting ourselves just to Gandhian nonviolence. We've been influenced by the work of researchers such as Dr. Gene Sharp, who took more of a utilitarian approach, a more kind of power-focused approach, rather than a kind of an ethical approach to nonviolence. We're influenced by other religious traditions, whether it's Christianity or Islam, Judaism, Buddhism, and others. So we feel like the nonviolence universe is an exciting one. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of differences of opinion, frankly, in the nonviolence universe. We think that's okay. We think the big family of nonviolence is a good one. And it's been a great privilege to work with people around the world. Most social change struggles we have are not pure nonviolent movements or pure violent movements. Even the great Indian, South Asian resistance to the British colonialism that was led by Mohandas Gandhi and Abdul Ghaffar Khan was not 100% nonviolent. There were, as you know well, there were those that used violence. There are also violent struggles where there are also nonviolent components. In lots of wars, there's also lots of nonviolent resistance, for example. So there's a mixture. The book really surveys the field of nonviolent tactics now in the 21st century. Gene Sharp did this in 1973, and I've surveyed it now. And we see that there's enormous amounts of creativity and nonviolent struggle going on in so many different dimensions with so many different new kinds of methods and tactics. And particularly in the digital realm, now that we have the internet, there are a whole new field of arenas of not just nonviolent communication, but nonviolent non-cooperation and intervention. And we want people around the world to realize that if they're in despair, that they should go to this toolbox, the book. And then I have a database too that goes along with it, where we're adding every day new tactics and new examples of tactics. And people can say, wow, I never thought of that. Maybe I can try that in my circumstance. We're up to 350 tactics that we have in our database. You can find that at the Nonviolence International website. And we would ask all of you to join us and make it your database and let us know of new examples and new tactics that we can put in the database to inspire people to realize that the toolbox of nonviolence is enormous and growing. And there's a lot of creativity.